Thanks, Zehra. Thanks for your organization and all of you. Share now my presentation. The presentation is based on the early Bronze Age material from our campaigns of Karagümrük excavation here and survey in the Lake Van Basin and Mount Ara. On the border of Eastern Anatolia, Mount Ara and Lake Van have exceptional positions in the nearest, owing to their location on the main routes between Anatolia, Mesopotamia, the Caucasus, and Iran, as you see in map. Lake Van, Mount Ara, and Upper Euphrates basins are the most suitable for the Eastern Anatolia. The topography of the highland to the east of the Upper Euphrates River is defined by the high mountain ranges and volcanoes of Nemrut, Süphan, Aladağ, Tendrek, and then Ara, which have abundant obsidian deposits. The region's vast and richest pasture lands, high plateaus, and agricultural areas in river valleys are located between these volcanoes. The mounds in the highland of Eastern Anatolia are small in size, unlike the Upper Euphrates Basin. However, the thickest layers of the mounds are from EBA. Among the 381 settlements studied in our survey, 80 belong to the EBA, and 22 of these are EBA fortified sites. The EBA pottery collected from these sites is in the Kura Araxes tradition. Now you see all of the sites that we studied in our survey in the Lake Van Basin and Mount Ara region. Mount Ara at the northeastern edge of the Eastern Anatolia is important for the region, both cultural and geographical features. Is surrounded the major size of Melikli, Karakoyunlu, Bulakbaşı, and Bozkurt and Suluçam are described as complex settlement. These main sites are located where the lava flows join the plains, as you can see here. They contain mounds, cemeteries, and fortresses spreading over a wide area with a horizontal stratigraphy covering a long chronological sequence from the Chalcolithic period to the Middle Iron Age Urartu or the Late Iron Age or Achaemenid period. They were located in central geographic areas of lowlands and next to fertiles, which were favorable for agriculture, pastures, highlands, and main routes. Another common feature of them are location in areas rich in water. Settlement complexes contain primary administrative or political centers of the territory in the Iron Age. These sites are very important for the Chalcolithic and also EBA sites. Yes, Mount Ara. No systematic excavation has been carried out in the region of Mount Ara except Kültepe, Melekli, and Melecami Bozkurt mounds. Petro made limited excavations at Melekli Kültepe here, and only three mounds investigated by Kökten and Burney in their survey. Published material of Kültepe Melik is quite insufficient, unfortunately, and the absence of the stratigraphical records is the problem. Some unstratified material came from our Bozkurt Kurgan excavation. According to our survey, evidence of the Chalcolithic and early Bronze Ages in Mount Ara concentrated where the lava flows of the mountain where they meet plains. Here you can see and here. Most of these sites and key sites were located in the Iğdır Plain in the Aras Valley. Additionally, a Kura Araxes fortified site at Kalecik Suluçam and the Kurgan at Mount Karasu Aras, which is the opposite of the Mount Ara. Kültepe Mount is situated in Melekli settlement complex on the northern slope of Mount Ara. Actually, Petrov excavated a small mound in Kültepe and a columbarium, Urartian columbarium, on the southern side of the mound. But this site is a wide area. It contains all of this area. We realized that in our survey. This area must have been the central site of the region for the earlier period. Here you can see Kültepe material from Petrov excavation, some Kura Araxes period. Yes, here is the Kültepe mound, which is the Petrov excavated here, and Urartu columbarium here on the south of the mound. And some Kura Araxes shards from the Kültepe that we collected in our survey. Another site of the Mount Aru, Melecami Mount, is situated in Bozkır Settlement Complex on the southern slope of Mount Aru in Doğubayazıt Plain. Here, on the southern Kafkasya Pass, here is a small mount in Bozkurt village here. Actually, we excavated here some about 45 kurgans here. And here you can see mount location. Middle late Chalcolithic and early Bronze Age pottery, which is the earliest materials of the site, came from the Melecami Mount. It's a small mount. Owing to its location in the Kurgan Cemetery, there are many small kurgans on it. Some shards of Middle Late Chalcolithic and Kura Araxes came among the kurgans. Because of this, we couldn't identify the structure of the Chalcolithic and Early Bronze Age settlements here, unfortunately. Yes, the kurgans of the Bozkurt here on the top of the mount, there are many kurgans on it. And just a few pieces we collected among the kurgans in the Melecami Bozkurt Mount. Yes, Lake Van Basin. Excavations carried on the Van Fortress, Urartu'nun capital of Tuşba, Dilkaya, Karagündüz, Çelebiba and Otbiçer Mounds. Except for Karagündüz and Dilkaya, they are small scale excavations. Otbiçer is a neo excavation. Previous works in Tilki Tepe and Kalecik Mounds have limited data, and also they have stratification problem. Yes, of the 271 sites that we investigated during our survey at the whole of the Lake Van Basin, only 6 sites were dated to the EBA. In addition to these sites, the total number of those surveyed by Kökten, Bernie, and Mitchell Rodman and Hanifi Biber are located mainly on the Muş Plain and here, some in the Bulanık Plain is 36. 21 of these sites were revisited by the teams. Charles Burney also investigated some sites in the northern and northeastern sites of basin. Most of the EBA 45 sites are located in the Lake Van Basin and 101 sites of belong to the Kura Araxes and a total size of 312. Yes, Çelebiba Mount is located on the northern shore of Lake Van at the confluence of the Zilan River. A Selçuk cemetery lies on it. Here you can see Çelebiba Mount. It's excavated by the Abdüselam Uluçam in the earlier 90s. Yes, EBA pottery from Çelebiba was found in the trenches on the northwestern slope of the mount here, you can see, and Kura Araxes shores from these trenches. Ernis is important for us. It's a big settlement complex located on the northern shoreline of Lake Van here, this area. And studied in our survey and previous works. Actually, Afiverzen excavated many early Iron Age graves in Ernis. Ernis is ancient name, now it's called Ünseli. And also Kirsop and Silva Lake made a short survey here. The first excavation excavated by Mar during the First War. There is no information about this excavation, unfortunately. Charles Burney investigated just the station at Aşağıki Çıkıran here. Lastly, Veli Sevin and me conducted an intensive survey in this area. Yes, there are many settlements in Ernis settlement complex from EBA to the Urartin period. But Evditepe on the shore is a small Kura Araxes settlement. There is no visible architectural remains of EBA because of the there is early Iron Age fortress on it and the big cemetery here, early Iron Age cemetery there is. Even though the Kura Araxes settlement under the early Iron Age fortress is evident, some of the EBA pottery published by Burney and in the name of Ernis, but it's problematic, as he also reported. There is no exact evidence on the fine support that 61 vessels that Burney published brought to the Van Museum from Ernis. This acquisition was claimed to have been found accidentally in a stone cist grave in Ernis in 1935. And this Kurarak sisters that we collected from the Evditepe under the early Iron Age fortress. Yes, Charles Burney, I think you all of know these vessels because Burney, Charles Burney published them for Ernest. In the early Iron Age cemetery surrounding the Evditepe, where the Kuraraksa settlement was studied, no evidence was found in the excavation and our and other surveys, unfortunately. There is a confusion about the Ernest pottery. I don't think so that they came from Ernest, because we studied about this subject in the museum. In the museum records and also in the field. Yes, another small site, Kalecik, is a mound and small Urartian fortress on a rocky hill. It's located north of the capital of Tuşba. Here one fortress, Urartian capital of Tuşba, and capital cemetery is here, and Kalecik. The Tuşba cemetery extends up to here. It was probably an outpost of the capital. Kirsop and Silva Lake excavated here in 1938 and 1939. Unfortunately, the records is absence now, but there is a thick layers of EBA here. It's clear we studied in our survey. One fortress mound, yeah, Urartian capital Tuşba, lies on the northern side of the lake and on the eastern shore of lakes. It is excavated several times, and the material of this presentation is from Sevin and Tahran excavation, which I was a team member. Here you can see a fortress and the mound on the northern side of the fortress. Yes, unfortunately, the EBA material Kuraraksa shards came from a sandwich on the northern side of the mound here. I studied here, but a few material from EBA because of the small trench really. Tilkitepe is an important site of the region. A small mound that lies on the eastern shore of Lake Van, just south of the Van Fortress. Here you can see, this is the Kofman map. Van Fortress, Tuşba, Tilkitepe, and Kalecik, and Toprakkale also is Urartian size. Here you can see Tilkitepe, Van Fortress, and Kalecik that I showed you before. As you know, Korkman collected and published all of the Tilkitepe material, but there is a stratigraphic problem really. And a few Kuraraksa pieces was published in this publication. Dirkaya is a small mound on the eastern shore of Lake Van and the confluence of the Güzelsu River. It's a small mound. Unfortunately, is distracted by the lake, excavated by Altan Çilingiroğlu. Is a here you can see mound and some plans of the Dilkaya EBA levels. Is a village settlement. A plan consists of the rectangular and round structures built in next to each other. Also, it has a thick layers of EBA and some shards of the Dilkaya excavation, Kuraraksa shards. And Karagündüz, here you see now, it lies on the northeast of Van, on the northeast shore of Lake Erçek. It's a big lake, smaller of Lake Van, of course. Excavation Van Museum and Veli Sevin in the earlier 90s. Also, I was a team member in this excavation. There is also an early Iron Age cemetery on the eastern side of the mound. Yes. Unfortunately, it's distracted by the lake also because the waters of the lake is rising here, Karagündüz Mound, and also modern Karagündüz Mound lies on it. Here is the EBA levels, the last period of the Kuraraksa period in the mound. Considering that some pieces were found on the surface and virgin soil couldn't be reached in our excavation, the first settlement at the mound may go back to the early phases of the EBA. Also, there is a thick deposit under the EBA levels, almost 6 or 7 meters. We didn't excavate that part. The most important period is EBA in the mound, as in the rest of the highland of the Eastern Anatolia. In the building level EBA in Karagündüz 7, a mud brick architecture was identified. There is no stone architecture here. There are some complex surrounding, it is a strip in 5 meters here, you can see. It can be a part of settlement that has a radial plan, as we see in bulursak yol. Rooms has a rectangular plan. Only there is a small piece wall belong to the round plan here you can see. Early Bronze Age level were studied in five trench. Unfortunately, this level belong to the late EBA. As I said to you, we didn't excavate at the lower period. Here is the secret and the buildings. And coral access vessels from Karagündüz. The second type of settlement is fortresses or rocky settlements, which are situated on foothills, again in lowlands. These are the first evidence of Eastern Anatolia we discovered in our survey. Contrary to settlements on the mounds, fewer EBA fortified sites have been found. Almost all of them is located in the richest river valleys or plains of agricultural areas and connection with the main roads in the region. They are mainly located in settlement complexes that I said to you before. Nevertheless, settlements, EBA settlements have been found in the highlands so far. There is no settlements in the highlands, just only a few EBA settlements and some graves have been found in the highlands so far. Fortified sites of EBA are located on a low or high rocky hills at the edge of the plains. Except some of them, the fortified sites are mainly set from Kuraraxes period to the Kingdom of Urartu in the region. Since the local fortresses in the region mainly started to appear in late Bronze, early Iron Age, and used until the Urartian period, sometimes Achaemenid period, it's hard to define if the fortified Kuraraxes settlements that were located on these sites were fortresses. Here we will see, I will show you present only some of the single layers EBA fortified sites. And you can see on map, six of them in the Lake Van Basin, one of them in Mount Ağrı here, Kalecik. Yes, this is on the northern part of the region, in the opposite of the Mount Ağrı. Here Mount Ağrı, and this is the Karasu Mounds, and there is a big lake here for the region, Balık Lake and Balık Suyu River Valley, and the Kalecik fortified settlements of EBA lies here. Balık Lake and the Balık Suyu stream is very important for the Mount region of Mount Ağrı, and here is a small agricultural land and also pasture land for the region. And it lies a settlement complex of Suluçem. Here is the contains late bronze early Iron Age fortresses and an Urartian fortress and some kurgans. As in the all of the settlement complexes, it is a long time span. EBA fortress or rocky settlement at Kalecik here you can see here, and there is an Urartian fortress here, late bronze early Iron Age fortress here, and there are many kurgans on this valley. It has no clear plan. Only some wall remains, which is made of the rough small stones, can be seen, but it shows old plan based on topography, as can be seen on satellite image. Here you can see here Kalecik. Yes. This is the as I said to you, this is the single layer of EBA, and about 300 Kuraraxes shards we collected here. Some of them from Kalecik. The another fortified site, Şehitlik, is in the Çaldıran Plain, on the gateway of the Lake Van Basin and Mount Ağrı, also Southern Kafkasya and Northwestern Iran, located again in a settlement complex of Yukarı Mutlu. Here is a late bronze, early Iron Age fortresses, some middle bronze age graves and the Urartian settlements, and Şehitlik fortress here you can see. And this is the lava flows of Tendurek. The settlement complex lies on the Tendurek lava hills, surrounded by the Çaldıran Plain or Bendimahi River Valley. Şehitlik is also settled in EBA. Kuraraxes period. And there is a Achaemenid fortress here in Aşağı Mutlu. It's a big settlement complex. Here, there is a, also a big spring at the bottom of the fortress. Here is the Iron Age fortress. Çaldıran Plain. And the Şehitlik is stated here. Bendemeyer River, which is in the Çaldıran and Muradiye Plains. Yes, Şehitlik Fortress and this land. EBA fortified settlement and Şehitlik with a small, with a rectangular plan is made of rough small stones like Kalecik in the Mount Ara region. The surrounding wall is 160 in the northeast and is 250 in the south, because I can see traces of buildings with a square rectangular and square plans can be inside here. Some rooms from inside at the surrounding wall. Again, we collected many Kuraraksiz shards here, about maybe 260 Kuraraksiz shards we collected here. The Şehirtepe is a different because the small fortified site is located on the northern shore of Lake Erçek and on the Mehmedik Özal River Delta, which lies east of the Lake Van on the Erçek, on the shore of Lake Erçek. Again, it's located at a settlement complex of Yukarı Gölalan. There is a mini Iron Age, early Late Bronze, early Iron Age and Urartian sites here. Şehirtepe is a small fortified site and on the shore. It is an oval plan. It's 30 and 20 meter and it's surrounded by a rectangular wall four and about 4 and 60 meters. The walls with rough medium sized stones and thickness of walls is 3 and 30. And some we collected a few pieces here, but this is the single layer of EBA fortified size. Şehirtepe fortified site is close to Karagündüz Mount, which is the one of the most important early Bronze Age settlement in the basin. They are opposite of each other. The last one is Kıratlı. It lies on the northeastern end of the Van Plain. Here is a high rocky settlement. Here you can see the fortified settlement is situated on a very high hill, overlooking the plain and lake, and again one fortress, Tushba. No clear plan is attested here. Only some wall remains, which is made of rough small stones, can be seen. And a few Kuraraksiz shards we collected here. In Eastern Anatolia, we have no much fortified sites, but in Iran, a new excavation and also Kral is the first studied in here. Köhne Şehir is it's close to the Lake Van Basin. Now it's excavating. The complete EBA city and their fortified city you can see here. They are close paralleled, which we found in our survey, but these are biggest ones. And some fortified sites from cross survey, there are many. I'm showing you some of them. These are from Northwestern Iran from Kral survey. Yes, our results show that the transition from the Chalcolithic period to the early Bronze Age, the most striking feature is the increase in number of the settlements. The region clearly reached an incredible density during the early Bronze Age, comparing in both earlier and later period, I mean Middle Bronze Age and Chalcolithic. Kuraraksiz settlements, which is familiar to us on mounds in the plains and the river valleys and fortified sites on the surrounding them, were located on the foothills surrounding these areas and lowlands, created the settlement pattern in the region. Except for a few cemetery and settlements in high pastures, they are located in important natural habitats in the region, in the plains, on the lake shores, and along the main communication routes. On the contrary, kurar access sites are quite rare in highlands and mountains in the eastern Anatolia. But fortified sites on foothills and some sites in high pastures indicate to relation with high pasture lands, suggest that the agropastoralism is practiced among settled nomadic and transient kurar access communities. However, there is a problem here. Contrary to the evidence from eastern Anatolia, a large number of kurar access settlements and fortified sites in northwestern Iran and southern Caucasus can be found in the highlands, even if the majority of these in the fertile plains. This contrasts with the evidence from eastern Anatolia, a situation that might have been explained the lack of the intensive EBA studies in eastern Anatolia. But the evidence of our intensive survey in Lake Van and Mount Aru regions doesn't support this suggestion. Moreover, while many EBA sites have been in eastern Anatolia, they nonetheless remain smaller in size than those identified in northern Iran and the southern Caucasus. Even though evidence only exists for the Lake Van and Mount Aru regions so far, the same result seems plausible for the fortified sites in eastern Anatolia. This is really problem for our region. I think we need more investigations and excavations. As you see, they are small scale excavations and there is a limited material. Finally, I would like to thank warmly to Republic of Turkey, Minister of Culture and Tourism, General Directorate of Monuments and Museums for giving permissions and supports. And also thanks to, again, Zehra and organizers of this meeting and all of you.